A study of high school students' experiences and understanding of cyberbullying.
Today, our topic is about cyberbullying. There are four sessions in our presentation. The first is introduction. The second is method. The third is findings. The final is conclusion. Now let's start our first section, introduction.
Bullying is a very serious problem at school now. So the government and schools want to stop it.
But what is bullying? Bullying is an aggressive behavior that gives others harm. In general, there are four features. Intentional, harmful, repeated, and imbalance in power relationship.
Cyberbullying is different. It has four features of traditional bullying, but it has a very different features. Anonymity. Anonymity can make the victims hard to find who is a bully, so the students can mirror through the invisible attack.
This invisible attack is very severe and even makes people be ill. For example, on April 2015, Cindy Young, an entertainer in Taiwan, was committed suicide because of a series of attacking words posted on a fan page on Facebook called COVID Worker. The sad news has caught many people's attention and the society has begun rethinking the severity of cyberbullying.
For this reason, we want to study this topic. There are three purposes. First, the present situation of using the internet. Second, cyberbullying experiences and understanding. Third, the prevention of cyberbullying. Therefore, here are three research questions you can see on the slide. Next is our method.
In our study, there were 104 high school students who were from different departments, and we used questionnaire as our tool. This questionnaire was revised from home and close study. In order to fit in our present situation, we changed some questions.
Here's our procedure. First, we collected some data, such as news, articles, magazines, and so on. Second, we designed the questionnaire and we revised it many times. Third, we sent it to our schoolmate and classmate and to them back. Fourth, we used Excel to analyze this data. Finally, we finished this study with many discussions. Now, let's begin our findings.
We first answer the first research question. According to the findings, we can see that most of students are used to surfing the net by smartphone, and they often use the net at home. Based on the above tables, the students use the net for entertainment and communication every day. When they use the net for the internet, they always chat with their friends with instant messengers. Therefore, we can find out that the students were the internet overusers.
Research question 2 asks about the experiences and understanding of cyberbullying. From the tables, we can see most of the students were bystanders. They did not know who is bullies, but they forget their identity.
The table shows that the victims were possibly classmates and strangers, and the best under table 5. We have known that the teacher attacks more than other methods. Connecting to the above findings, we can know that because of the technical development, the police always gives the textual information to harm others.
When we ask about the experiences, students always respond the experiences of cyberbullying is about textual attacks to insult. Many present slander the others no matter what words they use. We can know that the most frequent cyberbullying methods went beyond physical attacks.
This slide shows the prevention of cyberbullying. We can figure that the prevention methods is very average. However, teaching making the concept of the and are the top one choice for the students. And then the students want to learn the interactive of internet. We can know that the teaching, the concept of law and interactive are the prevention methods.
this topic.